We, the jury, in the above entitled matter as to count one.
The murder of George Floyd by former Minneapolis police officer Derek Chauvin.
Find the defendant guilty.
Hands up!
Sparked outcry worldwide.
George Floyd!
Shining a light on systemic racism in policing.
We wanted readers to understand that if you are concerned about the racism that revealed itself when Derek Chauvin put his knee on George Floyd's neck, you should maybe also consider the racism that existed long before that happened.
Robert Samuels and Tolu Olorunnipa, both reporters at the Washington Post, decided to shine a light on Floyd's life growing up in Houston's Third Ward.
We knew that George Floyd had a story that was much more than the 10 minutes of video that so many people came to know, and as journalists, we wanted to reveal that story.
Their book, titled His Name is George Floyd, One Man's Life and Struggle for Racial Justice, examines the struggles and determination Floyd carried as a black man living in America while tracing Floyd's family roots.
We decided to go back and talk to his family members, talk to the people who grew up with him, talk to his teachers and his coaches, and also do some ancestry. It was important for us to bring that level of empathy to telling his story. That didn't mean that we shied away from covering his hard moments.
To take Floyd's story outside of what we've seen, the narrative, when did that become a priority for you both?
We're hoping that we could help to show readers that if you looked to the past, they have reverberations.
George Floyd was a descendant of someone who was quite wealthy, who had been born enslaved, but worked really hard after receiving his freedom and earned his way to 500 acres of land in North Carolina. And it was important for us to show how the loss of that land and how that land was stolen and taken away from him impacted George Floyd several generations later.
As the world remembers the impact of Floyd's murder and the movement that followed, both authors hope the calls for change continue.
Have things changed?
The question is not whether or not things will ever change. There is a feeling that things have to change. That systemic racism has to go away. And the question for readers is, will they join in the process?